Let us go for the general heat conduction equation. General heat conduction equation. So, as far as this heat transfer is concerned, we mainly depend on the law of conservation of energy. So, here, when we talk about this general heat conduction equation, we need to consider three coordinate systems. First one is Cartesian coordinate system. The first one is Cartesian coordinate system. The second one is cylindrical coordinates. And the third one is spherical coordinates. So these are the three coordinate systems what we consider in this entire heat transfer concepts. So the first coordinate system is Cartesian coordinate system. So in this Cartesian coordinate system, we know that we have x, y and z axis. X, y and z axis will be there here. Now, when it comes to this cylindrical coordinates, here we will have r, z and phi, r, z, phi. Whereas in case of spherical coordinates, we take r, theta and phi as the coordinates that we consider. Now, let us talk about this general heat conduction equation in Cartesian coordinates, the first one. So, let me explain this by using the derivation. So, general heat conduction equation in Cartesian coordinates. So, let me consider a cuboid. So, let me consider a cuboid like this. So, in this cuboid, I will just cut a small element from this so that the element looks like this. The element looks like this. Now, let me consider this as the x-axis, the axis, this as the y-axis, and here this one we are calling it as z-axis. Now let me consider the dimensions in the x-direction of this wall are dx, the thickness. In the y-direction, this thickness we are talking at as dy, and this one let me consider this as dz. Now let us take the volume of the element. Volume of the element. Volume of the element, let me take it as dv. This will be equal to dx, dy and dz. So, this is the volume of the element what we have considered here. Now, let me take the x direction first. X direction. If we take the x direction, now the heat that is entering into the element is taken as Qx. So, Qx is the amount of heat that is entering the element, and the amount of heat that is leaving the element in x direction, we call it as Qx plus dx. So, the amount of heat entering the element in x direction is Qx, whereas the amount of heat leaving the element is Qx plus dx. Now, the heat entering the element, we can call it as heat influx. Heat influx. So, this is given by Qx, which will be equal to minus K, the thermal conductivity of this material, multiplied by area. So as far as this conduction is considered, I told you that the area that we have to consider is the area that is perpendicular to heat flow direction. The area that is perpendicular to heat flow direction is this area, if you observe. So this area is nothing but dy into dz. So dy into dz is the area that is perpendicular to heat flow direction, dy dz, multiplied by temperature gradient, that is change in temperature with respect to the distance. So the distance in the x direction or thickness in the x direction is taken as dx. So therefore, heat influx qx will be equal to minus k into dy dz into dt by dx. So this is the amount of heat entering the element. Now let us talk about the heat leaving the element. So the heat leaving the element, we can call it as heat efflux. Heat efflux, which is qx plus dx. Now we can write this qx plus dx as qx, that means the amount of heat entering the element, plus dou by dou x of qx multiplied by dx. So why we are writing dou by dou x of qx is, see here, as this heat flows through this thickness, there will be a variation with respect to the distance. So therefore, we need to take dou by dou x of qx and multiplied by the total thickness in that direction is dx. So that means the change in heat transfer with respect to the distance multiplied by the total distance will give us the amount of heat that is transferring through this particular part. This is heat efflux. See, here what we consider is, we don't consider the entering heat or leaving heat. We just consider what will happen within this element. So the amount of heat transferred within this element, if we take, that we can call it as dqx. So we can take that amount of heat transferred within this element in the x direction as dqx. That will be equal to the heat influx minus heat efflux. Why we are writing heat influx minus heat efflux is, the amount of heat that is available at this particular portion will be more than this one. So therefore, it can be written as qx minus of qx plus dx. So this can be written as qx minus qx plus dou by dou x of qx into dx. So that will be dqx here. Now from this, this can be written as qx minus qx, which will be equal to 0. And we can write this simply as minus dou by dou x of qx into dx. Dou by dou x of qx into dx. Now instead of this dou by dou x, we will write d by dx for easy understanding. So minus d by dx of qx. Qx is nothing but this total term. This can be written as minus k dy dz into dt by dx whole multiplied by dx. Now if you observe carefully, we can't differentiate k, y and z, dy dz with respect to x. As these are not differentiable, we can bring them out as constants, and this dx is always out of this differentiation range. So therefore, what we can do is, we can write that particular equation like this simply. dqx is equal to minus of minus, that becomes plus, k into dx dy dz, which is nothing but the volume of the element, multiplied by dy dx of dt by dx, can be written as d square t by dx square. So d square t by dx square. So this will be the heat transferred in the element in x direction. So heat transferred in the element in x direction is k into dx dy dz multiplied by d square t by dx square. Now Similarly, if we consider in the y direction, so let me consider the heat entering into the element in y direction is qy. The amount of heat leaving the element in y direction is qy plus dy. Now, the heat transferred within this element in the y direction can be taken as dqy is equal to k into volume of the element dx dy dz multiplied by d square t by dy square. That's all. So that is how we get dqy. So similarly, if we take in the z direction, so z direction, the amount of heat that is entering is in this direction. Let us consider it as qz, and it is leaving the element in this direction. So qz plus dz. Now, dqz will be equal to k into dx dy dz multiplied by d square t by dz square. So this is the amount of heat transferred in the element in x direction, y direction, in z direction. Now, let us take point A, which is heat transferred in element in all directions. So heat transferred in the element in all directions, if we take, so that will be nothing but dqx plus dqy plus dqz. So this is heat transferred in the element in all directions. Now if you observe carefully, in all these three, k dx dy dz, k into volume of the element is same. So therefore, taking k into dx dy dz common in all the three terms, k dx dy dz is taken common in all these three terms, what will be remaining is d square t by dx square plus d square t by dy square plus d square t by dz square. So this will be the heat transferred in element in all directions. Now let us go for B. So this is heat generated within the element. Heat generated within the element. So when we talk about this heat generated within the element, see, every material in the universe, because of certain atmospheric variations or temperature variations, will generate certain amount of heat per unit volume. So the amount of heat generated per unit volume is taken as small qg. So I'll write it here, heat generated per unit volume multiplied by volume of element will give us the total heat generated within the element. So heat generated within the element will be heat generated per unit volume multiplied by volume of the element. Now this heat generated per unit volume is taken as small qg. So let us take it as small qg. So B, I am writing it here, this is equal to small qg, this is heat generated per unit volume multiplied by volume of the element is dx dy dz. So this will give us B, heat generated within the element. Now see, initially when there are no heat transfers, this body will possess certain temperature. So because of that temperature, there will be certain amount of internal energy within this body. Now, as there are heat transfers in all the directions and there is internal heat generation within the element, what will happen is there will be a change in internal energy of this element because of all these effects. So because of all these effects, there will be a change in internal energy. Now, let us consider C as change in internal energy. Change in internal energy. So change in internal energy, the formula for change in internal energy is mass into specific heat into change in temperature. With respect to time, we have to consider in this particular case. So T is temperature and tau represents time here. So mass into specific heat into dT by T tau. See here, I have written only C because as we are taking considering solids, for solids, specific heat at constant pressure and specific heat at constant volume will be same. So that's why I am simply writing mass into specific heat only C here into dT by T tau. The value of Cp and Cv varies drastically only in case of gases, but in case of solids, both will be same. So mc into dT by D tau. Now mass can be written as density into volume. So density into volume is dV multiplied by C into dT by T tau. So this can be written as rho into dx dy dz into C multiplied by dT by D tau. So this is the change in internal energy of this element. Now remember that the change in internal energy of this entire element is because of the heat transferred in the element in all directions and the internal heat generation within the element. So these two, A and B, are the cause for change in internal energy of the element. So therefore, if we write energy balance expression, we should write that energy balance expression like this. A plus B is equal to C. So that will give us the energy balance expression here. So A plus B is equal to C. Now here A is nothing but K into dx dy dz multiplied by d square t by dx square plus d square t by dy square plus d square t by dz square plus B is nothing but small qg into dx dy dz. This is equal to the change in internal energy, which will be rho dx dy dz into C into dt by t tau. So this will be the energy balance expression what we get for this particular case here. Now dividing this whole thing k dx dy dz, we will get d square t by dx square plus d square t by dy square plus d square t by dz square plus qg by k is equal to rho c by k into dt by dt. Now this one can be written as 1 by alpha into dt by d tau. So this is the general heat conduction equation in Cartesian coordinates. So that means this is the equation of heat conduction in three dimensions. Right. Now here we came across a term called alpha, where this alpha is thermal diffusivity. Which is given by K by rho C, and K is thermal conductivity, we know that. And rho C we call it as heat capacity. See, this thermal conductivity defines how much amount of heat can transfer through the material. The rate of heat transfer can be defined by this thermal conductivity. Heat transfer can be defined by this thermal conductivity, whereas this heat capacity defines the absorption capacity of the material. So suppose, let us consider this material. This material has thermal conductivity some K and absorption capacity rho C. Absorption capacity means the amount of heat that this material can absorb and store. That we call it as absorption capacity. Whereas the conduction, thermal conductivity means the amount of heat that can transfer through this material. So that will be given by the thermal conductivity here. See, more the thermal conductivity, then more will be this thermal diffusivity. That means thermal diffusivity defines the degree of penetration of heat through the material. The penetration of heat through this material will be defined by this thermal diffusivity. Suppose if this material has more thermal conductivity and less heat capacity, then the diffusivity through this material will be more. The thermal diffusivity through this material will be more. Whereas if this material absorbs more amount of heat and the thermal conductivity of this material is less, then what will happen is the thermal diffusivity alpha will be less. That means heat cannot transfer at a faster rate through the material. So the rate of heat transfer can be defined by the thermal diffusivity of the material here. Okay. Now this thermal diffusivity is also a material property because it is depending on other material properties like thermal conductivity, density of the material and specific heat of the material here. So this is the general heat conduction equation in Cartesian coordinate system. See, from this particular equation we can get certain other equations. So these equations are very important. We have to remember those. And those are the first one, the equation. So if we take the first one, let us consider steady state with internal heat generation. Steady state with internal heat generation. So when we are talking about steady state, remember that there is no change in temperature with respect to time. So that means when we are talking about this steady state, this particular steady state, we need to consider dT by d tau is equal to 0. There is no change in temperature with respect to time. So therefore, as dT by d tau is equal to 0, this total RHS term will become 0. So therefore, the equation will be like this. So d square T by dx square plus d square T by dy square plus d square T by dz square plus qg by k equal to 0. This equation is called Poisson's equation. This equation we call it as Poisson's equation. Right? Whenever we come across steady state with internal heat generation, that equation is Poisson's equation in this particular case. Now let us go for the second condition. Unsteady state unsteady state without internal heat generation. See, unsteady state means there will be change in temperature with respect to time. And he said without internal heat generation. When there is no internal heat generation, this QG term becomes zero in this particular equation. So therefore, we can write this same equation as d square T by dx square plus d square T by dx. Plus d square T by dz square is equal to 1 by alpha into dt by d tau. So this equation we call it as Fourier's equation. Fourier's equation. Fourier's equation is different and Fourier's law is different. See, in Fourier's equation we are taking unsteady state condition, whereas in case of Fourier's law of heat conduction we consider steady state condition and no internal heat generation, and there we consider only one dimensional. When it comes to Fourier's equation, we take unsteady state condition without internal heat generation, but we consider the three dimensional analysis here. So this is Fourier's equation. Now coming to this next equation, steady state with no internal heat generation so steady state with no internal heat generation means that equation can be written as d square T by dx square plus d square T by dy square plus d square T by dz square is equal to 0 without internal heat generation and steady state. So this can be written as del square T equal to 0. So this equation we call it as Laplace equation. So this equation we call it as Laplace equation. So these are the very much important equations that we have to learn here. So no need of remembering all these derivations. Try to remember the equation. It will be helpful while solving the questions and all. Right. Now let us go for general heat conduction equation. Cylindrical coordinates. Now, so general heat conduction equation in cylindrical coordinates. Now let me consider this as a cylinder. Let me consider this as a cylinder. I will take a small elemental piece from this cylinder so that it looks like this. Small element I am considering. So this is the element what we have considered. This is the element we have considered here. Now, this one, let us assume that it makes some angle d phi at the center. And let me consider from the center, this is at a distance of r. This is at a distance of r here. Now, let me consider the thickness in this particular direction as dr. So, I am considering the thickness in this particular direction as dr. And here, the thickness in this direction, let us consider it as dz. The thickness in this direction, we are considering it as dz. And if you observe, this was in the form of an arc. So, therefore, arc length will be radius multiplied by the angle made by the arc. So therefore, this direction thickness will be r d phi. So the thickness in this direction is r d phi. Now therefore, volume of the element if we consider, volume of the element if we take dv is equal to dr r d phi dz. So this is the volume of the element what we come across. Now let us consider the heat transferred in the r direction. So this is r direction. So the amount of heat entering in the r direction, I am taking it as qr, and the amount of heat leaving in the r direction, let us consider it as qr plus dr. So qr plus dr is the amount of heat leaving the element in the r direction. So if we take r direction, the amount of heat entering the element in r direction, we can call it as heat influx, which is qr. This is equal to minus k into area. Area here, conduction we are taking. The area that we have to consider is the area that is perpendicular to heat flow direction. So if you observe, the area that will be perpendicular to the heat flow direction will be this area. So this area will be the area that is perpendicular to the heat flow direction in r direction. So therefore, this area is nothing but r d phi multiplied by this height of the element dz. So I'll write minus k into r d phi dz multiplied by dt by thickness. So the thickness of the element in the r direction is simply dr. So therefore dt by dr we can consider. So this is heat influx. Coming to the heat efflux, the amount of heat leaving the element in the r direction. So heat efflux is qr plus dr. So this can be written as qr plus dou by dou r of qr into dr. So dou by dou r of qr into dr. Now from this we got heat influx, heat efflux. I don't want heat influx or heat efflux. I just wanted to know what is the heat transferred within the element in this thickness dr. So therefore let us take it as dqr. So this will be equal to heat influx minus heat efflux. So this is given by qr minus of qr plus dou by dou r of qr into dr. So on solving this we get minus dou by dou r of qr into dr. So instead of this dou, let us take it as d. So therefore, what will happen is this equation dqr will be equal to minus d by dr of qr into dr. So minus d by dr of qr. So qr is nothing but this total term minus k r d phi dz into dt by dr whole multiplied by dr. Now, With respect to R, we can't differentiate this K, d phi dz, but R is differentiable within this one, and this dr is outside the differentiation range. So therefore, minus of minus, it becomes plus K dr d phi dz into dy dr of R dt by dr. That is what is remaining here. So K dr d phi dz d by dr of R dt by dr. This is in the form of d by dx of uv. So if we apply uv rule, we will get the answer for this particular case here. Now let me apply the uv rule for this case. Dqr will be equal to K dr d phi dz d by dr of r dt by dr. This can be written as u into d by dx of v. So that means d square t by dr square plus v into d by dx of u. So that means dt by dr into dr by dr will become 1. So that will be the uv rule what we can use here. Now try to remember this particular expression. We will be utilizing it one more time. Now from this we can write K dr r d phi dz. I am taking this r outside. So this becomes d square t by dr square plus 1 by r dt by dr. So this is the heat transferred in the element in r direction. So heat transferred in the element in r direction formula is this one. Now similarly, let us go for the phi direction. So this direction is very important, phi direction. So if we take the phi direction, the amount of heat that is entering into the element in phi direction will be like this. So this is Q phi, let us say. The amount of heat leaving the element in this direction will be Q phi plus the thickness in the phi direction you should take, that is R d phi. It is not d phi. Remember that the thickness in this direction is R d phi, not d phi. Okay, so Q phi plus R d phi we have to consider here. Now the heat influx, heat influx is Q phi, which is equal to minus K into area. Area that we have to consider is the area that is perpendicular to heat flow direction. So therefore this area we have to consider that is perpendicular to heat flow direction. So therefore this will be equal to dr dz. So that area is nothing but dr dz multiplied by the change in temperature with respect to the thickness of the element. So thickness of the element in the phi direction is R d phi and it is not d phi. Try to remember this, it is R d phi. Now coming to heat efflux. Heat efflux, this is Q phi plus R d phi. This is equal to Q phi plus dou by R dou phi of Q phi into R d phi. So with respect to the thickness we have to differentiate. So R dou phi we have to consider here. See, I don't want heat transferred in the element. Heat entering the element or heat leaving the element. I just wanted to know what is heat transferred within this thickness of R d phi. So therefore let us consider that as dq phi. This will be equal to q phi minus of q phi plus R d phi. So this will be equal to q phi minus of q phi plus dou by R dou phi of q phi into R d phi. So that is the condition here. So from this you will get minus dou by R dou phi of Q phi into R d phi. So this is what we are going to get here. So d Q phi is this one. Now if I substitute Q phi value, this value in that particular equation, so I will write this one like this, d by R d phi for easy understanding, of Q phi into R d phi. Now from this, Q phi value is this one. So therefore, d Q phi will be equal to minus d by R d phi of Q phi is nothing but minus k dr dz into dt by R d phi of R d phi. So this is the case. So we can't differentiate k, so we can bring it outside. Dr dz cannot be differentiated with respect to R dou phi. So therefore this equation can be written as k dr, this R d phi is out of differentiation, so R d phi dz multiplied by 1 by R square. So 1 by R here, 1 by R, 1 by R square into d square t by d phi square. So this is heat transferred in the element in phi direction. So dq phi value is this one. So we got heat transferred in the element in R direction as well as in phi direction. So in the z direction, dqz will be equal to k into volume of the element dr R d phi dz into d square t by dz square. This is simple case. So this is heat transferred in the element in z direction. So we got heat transferred in the element in all the three directions. Therefore, similar to the Cartesian coordinate systems, we will develop the equation. Let us take it as A. Here A is heat transferred in element in all directions. This will be equal to dqr plus dq phi plus dqz. Now if you observe all this dqr, dq phi and dqz, this k into volume of the element, this is constant. So therefore what we are going to do is, let us take k into volume of the element constant, k dr r d phi dz multiplied by, in the r direction we got d square t by dr square plus 1 by r dt by dr plus 1 by r square d square t by d phi square, this is in the phi direction, plus d square t by dz square, this is in the z direction. So heat transferred in the element in all the three directions we have got here. Now let us take heat generated within the element. So this is nothing but heat generated per unit volume, which is given by small qg, that means watt per meter cube will be the unit of this one, multiplied by volume of the element is dr r d phi dz. So this is volume of the element. Now let us go for the change in internal energy. The change in internal energy is equal to mass into specific heat into dt by d tau. This mass can be written as density into volume, which is dr r d phi dz into dt by d tau. This is the expression. Now coming to the energy balance, you should take A plus B equal to C. So when you take A plus B equal to C, K dr r d phi dz multiplied by d square t by dr square plus 1 by r dt by dr plus 1 by r square d square t by d phi square plus d square t by dz square plus qg, this is the second term, into dr r d phi dz. This will be equal to rho c into dr r d phi dz multiplied by dt by d tau. This is the case here. Now dividing this total thing, k dr r d phi dz, we are going to get the general heat conduction equation in cylindrical coordinates. So let me rub this. So if we divide that expression by k dr r d phi dz, then that equation becomes d square t by dr square plus 1 by r dt by dr plus 1 by r square d square t by d phi square plus d square t by dz square plus qg by k is equal to 1 by alpha into dt by d tau. So you will get rho c by k, you can write it as 1 by alpha. So this will be the general heat conduction equation in cylindrical coordinates. So these two belong to r direction. So this is for the phi direction and this is in the z direction. So this will be the general heat conduction equation in Cartesian coordinates. Okay, let's have a break. After that, we'll discuss.